in class 9. In the previous lesson, you learned about the local self-governing institution, how it came into existence, and you came to know about the difference between local government, local self-government, and the three-tier structure of local self-governing institution, which was established or came into effect from 1993. There you also learned about the Gram Sabha, which is one of the part of the Gram Panchayat, which is in the grassroots level of the three-tier structure. There you learned about the composition of the Gram Sabha as well as their functions. Now, we'll try to understand the Gram Panchayat. When you see the Gram Panchayat, which was there as one of the third or the grassroots level of the three-tier structure, we have to see under two headings, that is Gram Sabha and the Gram Panchayat. The composition of Gram Sabha, their functions, we have already completed. Now, we'll understand the Gram Panchayat, its compositions and functions. The functions of Gram Panchayat, they are vast, very simple, and it's important for the examination point of view. If you memorize the functions, at least 2-3 functions from each headings, more or less the same is going to be repeated when we study about the Panchayat Samiti and the Jilla Parishad. So it's better that you memorize at least minimum 2 from each heading, which will be explained as we go ahead. Now, we'll see the Gram Panchayat. The Gram Panchayat, in the previous class, I told it's an executive. Executive wing of the Gram Sabha, or the executive wing in the grassroots level. It executes or puts into vote whatever decisions are taken by the Gram Sabha for the development, upliftment, and the progress of a particular village or the local area. Now, composition. The members of the Gram Panchayat are elected by the members of the Gram Sabha. Previous class you saw it. Gram Sabha or other registered voters of a locality are the members of Gram Sabha. And it is these members who elect the members of the Gram Panchayats. Got it? The members of the Gram Panchayats are elected by the members of the Gram Sabha from amongst its members, which means no person can be elected as a member of a Gram Panchayat if he or she belongs to another village or another locality. It usually is a member who is a member of that particular village. Did you get it? So, the members of the Gram Panchayats are elected by whom? The members of the Gram Sabha. Understood? Qualifications. Now, what are the different qualifications? Who all can be elected as a member of the Gram Panchayat? First one, should not be less than 21 years of age. So whosoever wants to get elected as a member of the Gram Panchayat should not be less than 21 years of age. Got it? Second one, should be a registered voter. So a particular member is qualified, is above 21, but he should be a registered voter of that particular village, then only he or she can be elected as a member of a Gram Panchayat. Got it? A person belonging to one village cannot be elected as a member of the village panchayat in the other village. So therefore, he or she should be a registered voter of a particular village. Then only he or she can be elected as a member of the Gram Panchayat. Third one, not disqualified by law. A person who is going to be elected, he or she should not be disqualified by law. Maybe he or she should not have any criminal records and so on. If there is any record of disqualification, according to the prevailing law in the country, a person cannot be elected as a member of the Gram Panchayat. Now, the last one it says, a person should be mentally sound. Mentally sound, which means his mental health should be good. No person would want a ill person, a sick person, mentally to be elected as a member of the Gram Panchayat. Added to that, with regard to composition, these are the qualifications. The ones who are qualified to become a member of the Gram Panchayat. So, besides that, seats are reserved for civil caste, scheduled tribes, and other backward communities. There are reservations of seats in the village panchayats. They will be elected. The seats are reserved for scheduled caste, scheduled tribes, and other backward community. Added to that, 50% seats are reserved for women. Before it was only 1/3, now because of the amendments and the changes, 50% seats are reserved for women. So here, the total strength of the panchayat in the particular village, let's say it's 12. So out of 12, 6 of them should be reserved for women. Okay? Qualifications, should not be less than 21 years of age, registered voter, should not be disqualified by law, and he or she should be mentally sound. Beside that, seats are reserved for scheduled caste, this is fine for scheduled caste, scheduled tribes, and other backward communities, and 50% seats are reserved for women. Now, once, and keep this in mind, they all are elected for a period of 5 years. Once the members of the village panchayats are elected, they elect a sarpanch who conducts the meeting of the village panchayat. Gram Sabha who conducts? The panchayat pradhan. Okay, who is known as the president. The meetings of the Gram Panchayat is conducted by the sarpanch who is elected from amongst the elected members, and these members are elected by the Gram Sabha. Got it? Added to that, the pradhans or the president and the vice president of the Gram Sabha are the ex-officio members. Ex-officio members of the village panchayat. Ex-officio means since they are the panchayat president of the Gram Sabha. Not panchayat president, since they are the president of the Gram Sabha. By virtue of their office as a president, they become the ex-officio members of the village panchayats. And all decisions are taken by majority vote. And if there is a tie, if there are 50% opposing, 50% let's say approving or accepting, there's a tie. So in case of a tie, Sarpanch has a casting vote. Sarpanch has a casting vote, that means he is the one who can decide whether to say yes or a no. So this is in brief about the Gram Panchayat, its qualifications, how they are elected, from where they are elected, and for how many years, who all can be the members or get elected as a member of the Gram Panchayat. When you see the composition, so we have elected members, who are the ones elected, you know it, that should be a registered voter, seats are reserved for certain castes, certain tribes and other backward club communities, 50% of seats are reserved for women, and besides that, the Pradhan of the Gram Sabha are the ex-official members of the village Panchayat, which works as an executive branch in the under the three-tier structure in the grassroots level. Now let's see some of the functions of the village Panchayat. As I told you before, it's there in your book, very simple, and they are very common. Please do memorize it, it will be useful for Panchayat Samiti as well as the Jilla Parishad, because more or less similar functions are performed by the other two, what we call institutions. Now your book talks about the different types of functions that a village Panchayat are to perform. And some of the functions, let's say like they are known as welfare functions or civic, which means it is the duty of the village Panchayat to provide welfare or to see that the welfare of the people are met at the village level. And some of the functions, it's there in the book, please do it, that is provision or providing safe drinking water facilities, to look after the healthcare facilities. And it is the duty of the village Panchayats to set up dispensaries and healthcare centers in the villages. Added to that, with regard to education, it is the duty of the village Panchayat to see the arrangements for primary and secondary education, that will set up schools, or to see that the schools are being set up in the villages. Next one, to look after the drainage system, looking after the, what's a footpaths, culverts, sea, street lighting, and so on. And the other important is to look after the welfare of the women. They all come under civic or welfare functions. That means to soon see the welfare of the people of the villages. Second one, the book, if you see it in your book, it's written as developmental. Developmental functions. That means to look after the development of the villages by providing rural electrification. Okay, provide electricity in the village or the rural areas. Then the next one will be in the villages. Most of the villages are farmers. So what is the function of the village Panchayat? To provide irrigation schemes to the villages or the members of the villages. Next one, there are poor people in the villages and all, and it is the duty of the village Panchayat to provide rural housing facilities especially to the poorer sections of the society. And these are also there in your book, the chapter number 4, you may please see to it. Besides that, there are some of the functions known as general administrative functions. General administrative functions, such as maintaining of births and records, registration of birth records, marriages, etc. in the villages. That means it is sort of an administration. then it is the duty of the village panchayat that they have to set up watchman, chowkidars, etc. in the villages. Okay? Then last one is helping the government in maintaining law and order and in the development of the rural areas. Yes, I have not explained in detail. It's there in the book. The look under the village panchayat performs several functions, and these functions are there under several headings in your textbook, such as welfare functions or the civic functions. If you consult the book, there you'll be seeing. There are the welfare functions. We have the functions like providing or provision of safe drinking water facilities to the villages. Second one, to look after or provide health care facilities, setting up dispensaries, hospitals, and health care centers at the villages. Then, arrangement of primary and secondary education, and to look after the drainage system in the villages, to look after the footpaths, culverts, to see about the street lights and so on, and look after the welfare of the women in the villages, especially the expectant mothers. Then we have the developmental functions. That is, the word itself says, to look after the development of the villages. How is it done? By providing rural electrification in their villages or the rural areas, and providing vocational and primary education, providing irrigation schemes to the villages, then provide rural housing facilities, especially for the poorer sections of the society. Now, yes, all these things cannot be done by the panchayat. It comes from the central government, it goes to the state government, and it's done at the village level. Got it? Then we have the third one. General administrative function. That means administrative work, such as maintaining or registering birth, death, or maintaining the records and the marriages in the villages. Next one, what was it? I would tell you, maintenance or look after the chowkidars, or employ someone as a watch guard in the villages. Then finally, helping the state government in maintaining law and order. If there are any doubts, please do consult your textbook and do post in the group. Thank you.